Filmora Pro Video Editor. Advanced editing, effects, and motion graphics made easy. This series of tutorials are going to show you the basics of editing in Filmora Pro from start to finish. Hi everyone, my name is Johnny, and in this tutorial we will learn how to import media into our project. We'll also learn how to use the media panel, the trimmer, and the viewer monitor. So, to start, let's import our media. This means choosing the files we want to use in our edit and bringing them into the project. We can import video files, audio files, and static images. Let's take a closer look at the media panel. There's a few ways we can import our media. We can simply drag our media from elsewhere on our PC to the media panel, or we can also double-click on the empty space in the media panel, click the import button in the corner here, or press Ctrl or Command I on our keyboard to bring up the file browser where we can choose which media we'd like to import. In the media panel, we see a list of imported footage, with their thumbnail previews on the left, which makes files easier to identify. Over on the right, we have the name of the file and its settings. We can also view our media in list mode. This will show only the name of the file and the icon to identify the type of file. This way, we'll be able to see more files without the need to scroll. If we click on the gears on the right, we can open the media properties window. This will let us check and modify some settings for the file. To rename a file, we can use the Media Properties window, or we can just select the file, hit Enter, and write the new name. Naming files correctly is crucial to avoiding losing time when you edit, especially when you're working with lots of files. That being said, changing the file names in Filmora Pro will not change their names on your computer. To keep files even more organized, we can create folders by clicking on the New Folder icon, writing down the name, and hitting Enter. Now we can click and drag files into that folder. We can choose to arrange our media alphabetically or by type of file in descending or ascending order. We can choose to group files by folders we've created, or we can group by media, which will automatically separate the files in audio and video, images, planes, and titles. If we can't find a file we've imported, we can search for its name in this box. We can import sequences of images so that they play as if they were frames of a video. For this, we need all of the image files to be inside a folder and named in order with the numbers on the end. We'll click on the arrow next to the import icon and then on image sequence, and then we'll select the folder with the images. In this case, I'll select these pictures for a time lapse, and Filmora Pro will import it as a video clip. If we click on a piece of media, it will open the trimmer panel. Here we can preview our media by clicking on the play icon or hitting the space bar. We can click on the previous and next frame icon to move frame by frame, or use the left and right arrow keys, which you will find handy when doing precise cuts. We can also use the L key to play forward and hit it again to play faster. The K key will pause the video and the J key will play it backwards. The next thing we can do is select the part of media we want to use by setting the in and out points. To do this, we're going to find the exact time we want this clip to start, and then we'll click Set In Point, or hit I on the keyboard. Next, we'll find where we want this clip to end, and we'll click Set Out Point, or hit O. When we do this, we'll see a blue section in the small timeline on the trimmer window, which represents the media we have selected. We can loop our playback by clicking on this icon or pressing Ctrl or Command L. When we do this, the trimmer will play back the selected part of media as a loop. On the bottom right, we can select how zoomed in or out we want our trimmer, by a certain percentage or scale to fit the size of the panel. We can also change it by scrolling while our cursor is hovering over the monitor. This will not affect the scale of our actual clip, but will only change the way we see it in this panel. Further down in this drop-down menu, we have the playback resolution where we can choose the quality of the preview of the trimmer. Higher quality will give us a better preview, but lower quality may be more responsive on some computers. So if you run into lag, it's a good idea to lower your preview quality. This won't affect your end product, of course. We can click and drag our footage straight from the trimmer to the editor panel to bring our clip into the timeline. If the project settings are different from the videos, a window will pop up and ask us if we want to automatically change our project settings to fit the media. Once we have some clips in our timeline, we can see them in the viewer panel. This panel is a monitor like the trimmer, but it will show us the entire edit instead of only one file. We can play, move frame by frame, select the in and out points of our edit, which is more important when we're ready to export, and also change the zoom and playback resolution, just like in the trimmer panel. So that's how to import media in Filmora Pro. To learn more about editing in Filmora Pro, make sure to check out our next tutorials. There's no limit to what you can make.